Thank you, Kenzie!
Oh, I didn't hear Kenzie's line.
Should have said teacup.
Thank you, Kenzie.
Ow!
Sorry, I was getting them off of you.
I know you were. But if they latch onto you, you can just press Y and, or not press Y, but repeatedly hit Y and then they
got a bit of treasure in that chest over there.
Just drop
the weapon
off.
You find inside may help with our little imp problem.
Wait, where is it? It's up here.
Get the god's hammer.
Oh.
That is a freakishly large hammer.
I'm okay with this. Oh, you have to fully charge it. Just a heads up.
This all hell got to offer?
Nailed it.
I summoned these imps to serve as my crew. I forgot what a handful they could be. Once aboard, they wouldn't listen to their captain. They ran amok in the bowels of the ship. They're swarming me!
Good God, they're swarming me!
That's kind of like something I would say in, what is it, in, Borderlands.
What pirate voice would that be?
Wow.
Wow, Gat, you're an idiot.
Zinyak's destruction of Earth had a profound impact on the afterlife. To heaven, it was a logistical nightmare. St. Peter's meticulous nature drove purgatory wait times to unbearable levels. Meanwhile, in Hell, where souls in pain were used as currency, it created a new era of prosperity for the wickedly enterprising. This economic boom resulted in the coffers of Hell to be overflowing, which in turn piqued the interest of the most notorious man that sailed the seven seas. Long had Blackbeard been a thorn in Satan's side, robbing tax collectors on a semi-regular basis. But the promise of an immeasurable fortune drove him to be even bolder. An arrangement was reached. Blackbeard would provide information on strategic targets in exchange for a share of the profit. Johnny, who was interested in murder, not money, happily agreed.
That sounds about right.
Yep. Can we go back to the singing?
No.
I grant ye the ability to summon my crew whenever they're needed.
And tutorial time.
We can now summon little imps.
Imps. His pirate chest.
Yep.
Alright, matey. It's time for your lesson. Let's summon me favorite scurvy-riddled hellion, the imp. Why don't you start off by summoning an imp to take out those enemies?
Oh.
There you go, matey. Now take down the other. Those little ankle biters are vicious. Now let's practice your aim. Take down the demons on the islands. Few things are as rewarding as pressing someone into service, am I right? Now get going. There's a whole wide world waiting to be plundered.
Oh, we can only summon one. Well, one each.
Yeah, but if they do that much damage, which we kind of need to go test right now. Wait, with... Rally Shakespeare.
Yeah, Shakespeare's one of them.
So it's Blackbeard, Shakespeare, the twins, and...
I don't know. I've only gotten Blackbeard before.
Yeah.
It is barnstorming.
Okay.
Gotta find more of these things.
Ayo, level up.
This is what I'm talking about.
What, you're 6?
Yep.
I'm still 5.
Ayo, finally. More imps. More imps too. So yeah, go ahead and get to 6, and then since we did it out of order, we have more summon stuff to unlock immediately.
All right then, that's good to know. It's up there.
All right.
There we go.
Oh, you hit 6.
No, I was, working on a barnstorming. Now I hit 6.
Gotcha. The people united, 1. Increase the health of husks that fight in your name. Huh. Oh, there it is, health regen. Oh, and if the husks die, they drop health.
That's nice.
Explosive resistance. Yes, please. Bonuses. Wage bonus. I need more wage for that, though. Melee super strength. I found my favorite thing.
Alright, I'm not flat broke.
Pretty much. Alright, you know what? Where did the spire go? Get over here.
Gotta pick it up.
I have 3 imps to do my bidding. They do that much damage. Holy crap.
Man,
I'm really good at killing people.
Hello.
Hi. Shoulda run.
I got the spire.
I noticed, thank you. I need to find an ammo shop. You get a good amount of money for doing those.
The spires? Yeah, yeah, we do.
What was the other thing I was about to do?
Let's see what these things can do.
Oh, you said vendor.
No.
There's a vendor over here.
Wage bonus, there we go.
I don't know why I'm going to the vendor, I'm flat broke.
You're going to it so I can find it.
Alright, well, I'm circling over it.
Okay, give me a second.
I'm just gonna make my viewers dizzy. And now the other way.
Don't look. He's trying to make you sick of him.
Gotta pick it up.
I mean, all I have to do is just play Minecraft for that.
Yeah, don't do that. Don't play Minecraft. Alright, I need, first off, get out of here. I want my Omega Omega, Omega, Omega back.
Got it.
Which one's Triple Omega? Is that the paddle?
Yes.
Okay. I'm probably going to stick with the hammer. I didn't use the... Well, it doesn't really matter to me, actually. I'm not using the melee too much.
Ammo. Alright, upgrades. For the SMG. I don't have enough. Got it. Alright, let's go get Shakespeare.
Is he in the building? I don't think he is. Is he on it?
Running out of juice.
No, he's in it.
I'm so used to I was so used to Borderlands for the first 5 minutes. That I tried to click left stick to run. I must move.
Lights up. William Shakespeare, humanity's greatest playwright, and hell's most diabolical purveyor of entertainment.
I want to know how
looks
he ends
on
up
as a brave mortal on an Orphean quest enters. The bard's interest is piqued, and he looks to test his visitor's mettle. The masked tragedies were used to enemies cowering as they approached. But soon they realized that they faced a foe with courage and nobility. Traits uncommon in the fires of perdition.
Thieves!
The inciting incident resolved. The time had come for rising action. The battle raged on below, and as bullets and blood flew, the bard arched a curious eyebrow. Could this mortal be the exact thing that Shakespeare needed?
Archler.
This battle's
or whatever.
Arise.
Yeah, see. Got him.
So much easier once we have Blast.
You got it.
The conflict resolved. Shakespeare eagerly awaited meeting the champion that dispatched so many of his men. Undoubtedly, they were here.
He's glitched.
Is he through the wall or something? Or glass? Down.
Shakespeare always had a soft spot.
When? What?
You saw him, right?
Yeah, I saw him at the very end.
In the land of the living, William Shakespeare is regarded as one of the most prolific playwrights of all time. However, to the denizens of hell, the bard is seen in a far different light. After selling his soul for fame and adoration, Shakespeare served in hell as Satan's spy master general.
What?
In doing his duty, Shakespeare would punish the souls he was investigating by forcing them to perform in grotesque passion plays for Satan's amusement. But in a Twelfth Night-esque twist, Shakespeare found himself living a double life. While he projected an image of cruelty, his heart was as soft as Jezebel's. In secret, he would tutor her on the classics and act out the works of his mortal days. When Satan found out, he cast Shakespeare out of the palace, believing that the poet would be tormented by the populace of hell, far out of Jezebel's sight. But Satan had not counted on the bard's cunning. Embracing his persona of master torturer, Shakespeare and his followers, the tragedies, took root in the entertainment district, biding their time for revenge.
So, what would you sell your soul for?
And so, Shakespeare called forth the Deus Ex Machina to bestow our protagonist with the arcane power of Force Stomp.
Fire away.
Who?
Dex? I don't know who that is.
Lights up. The mortal stands in the training grounds, eager to try out his new force stomp power on the group of demons in front of them.
Oh, first game.
Your suffering will be legendary.
One, only his, only his voice in is which in the second.
Bye, Scott.
Kills more demons with force stomp.
To battle.
Act 2, in which our protagonist is greeted by foul imps. Act 3, in which our protagonist learns that Force Stomp even works on flying enemies, enabling them to remove a Dark Inciter's shield before shooting them to death with bullets. There is also a mistaken identity and love unrequited. The day is won, and the curtain closes on our noble hero.
Oh.
Where'd you go?
I went up, because I jumped before. Still sent me into a ragdoll. Well done. Vlad.
It's easier every time.
Vlad the Impaler. I guess. Oh, hey, there's a spire right here.
I can do this all night. Oh, sorry. My bad.
Alright.
Alright,
it's gonna be a lot easier to clear these things out.
Yes, and I'm just gonna stick to summon. You can stick to stomp. Just so I don't accidentally pop you out. You weren't trying to kill me.
Okay, I'm definitely hearing some music there. What?
I was shooting the car. Okay. Thank you. I got run over by an ambulance.
This should be useful.
Yeah.
Exiting armored area, don't care.
Because we need all of those right now.
Clusters?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, no, some of these cars definitely have music playing.
Uh-huh.
Oh, you got the one I was about to go for. Good.
Count on these things.
The Thank you.
Dreams of success.
Whoops.
Shouldn't be that fun. Murder thing.
Nearby? What do those even do?
That's a thing for Blackbeard. But yes, I just know it's something for Blackbeard. So it'll help us later.
Okay. Later. Wow, look at all the ones over here.
I can try and find it. The glyph.
Nah.
Alright.
Woo!
nice. Fucking collectible. Want a turn? Yeah. Yeah.
There we go.
You won't be shooting me down.
Kept firing missiles off at me.
I was trying to get it, but everything down here was shooting at me.
Yeah. Keep in mind, if you fly too close to the lava.
Like the streams of lava?
No, like the river of lava or whatever.
Okay.
You will catch fire.
Noted.
However, it also seems to get you an achievement.
Wait, what?
Flying while on fire.
I'm low on health. I probably shouldn't do that.
I have a resistance to fire. I think.
Let me regen health and I'll try.
Oh, no, it's the lava spires that pop up. That's what it is. I just happened to find them. Yeah, it's fly 500 feet with, while on fire.
Alright then.
It's not that bad. Also, don't forget to upgrade stomp. Like, I definitely did.
Yeah, I probably should do that. Donk.
Oh! A little help.
You went down?
Yep. Come over here and stomp on these guys.
You're actually quite far away.
God, this feels
good. Oh, so I am. Alright, you're not gonna make it.
Nope. Damn! Right there!
Oh, you landed on me.
I was right there. I used all of my boost to get to you. Out of the frying pan. What achievement is that?
What's the small cost?
Wait, what?
It said you died, however, luckily your halo allows you to reform at a small cost.
I think it's just the wage.
You think I'm scared? Also, we're at 700.
Already? Jeez. Alright, can I upgrade now? Or are you gonna keep shooting at me?
Federation, believe me, it's easy to find people who lay it all on the line for next to nothing. Some folks think I had all this handed to me and I take advantage of people, but here's the God's honest truth. In life and in death, I worked for everything. Opportunities mean fuck all if you do nothing with them. Most of these poor bastards down here whine about their lot in life, but are...
Bitch, who are you?
The wall running came in handy.
So wait, how did you catch on fire from the river of lava?
I'm so sick of these guys.
You either touch it while you're going down.
The fuck did I do to you?
Or you can
wait for the flares.
I exist, but motherfuckers
wait for the flares,
always
yeah.
Gotta bring up the past.
Gotta be running out of these things.
Oh God. Did you just see the notification that popped up?
No.
One of 30.
Gotta pick it up.
Commentary discovered.
Oh God. We'll find plenty of those later.
Yeah, when we actually have the collector.
Best piece of advice my father gave me, and I ignored it because I was a fucking idiot. I was the director of special projects for Ultor, and I pissed it all away because my ambition got the better of me. The reality is that I'm a kingmaker, not a king. I'm not going to make that change.
That doesn't get old.
How can you stand against the horde?
All right, to Vlad.
This is bad timing. Let's see what these things can do. One more.
Almost missed that.
You're almost missing things. Meanwhile, I'm just over here upgrading everything because, you know.
Why not?
Tons available and...
Gotta pick it up.
Ooh. Imp detonate. Press Y to detonate all summoned imps on the battlefield, obliterating nearby enemies and any adversary.
You're with... 7, aren't you?
Yeah.
Alright then. How far into 6 am I? Kinda wish you'd show me. Okay, I'm almost 7.
Ooh, 5 flaps! Also, stamina recovery too. You land, get 50% back.
Yeah, I have that.
How?
I do have that, right?
I know you have at least.
That's level 5.
Oh, I'm just dumb and never got it. Okay. So you remember that castle I was talking about, where it was like, hey, let's go take care of this.
Yeah.
It was Vlad's.
The prison.
Huh.
And now I leveled up. What?
What?
The horn on the bus goes beep, beep, beep.
Are you scared by this? Or is that just me?
Little bit.
Alright.
What, if they wanted to torture you, why'd they use the short version of the song?
This is the short version?
Oh yeah. The wipers on the bus go swish, swish, swish. The hobo on the bus goes
My mom had like 80 of them.
Oh my god, this is not what I expected.
This is also going to get flagged. Probably.
I'm not sure, because I think this is a free use song.
I'm not gonna kill this guy yet.
Should I see him?
Yes.
I will fucking end.
Absolutely, you should.
Come, let us return to my castle. So we may plot our next steps.
Aren't you glad
in
I let you see that?
Yes. Oh my god, that was awesome.
Johnny led Vlad back to his castle, which since his incarceration became a haven for frat parties and squatters. But the systematic impaling of trespassers would have to wait. Vlad was a man of his word, and was eager to provide intel that could aid in hobbling Satan's armies.
I just thought about something. This is also going to be a really... I think this is going to be a really short game. Bestow upon you
this Stygian. I don't expect it to be long. I mean, it's definitely going to be shorter than 3 and 4, because this was originally designed as like a DLC campaign.
Aura?
Think of it like... I think it's like the buff in Saints Row 4.
Oh, is the...
Sorry.
Help Vlad claim his prestige by defeating the Tri-Omega clan at their favorite spot. I don't care if she's reunited with Kiki, Viola, and I are still sisters. What the heck happened between these two?
Which means you must activate the power and get close to an enemy
before
they will feel the cold embrace of the Stygian flames. Try it against these demons.
It works on each other, by the way.
Yeah. Get away from me.
Stay over there, I'll be over here.
Play too?
Oh, don't stand next to them when you do it.
Why?
You'll catch fire from yourself.
Now here comes a dark inciter. Use your aura, then get close to him to take down his shields. From there, you can finish him off with your pistol.
Ow.
This.
You've done it. Doesn't it feel good to watch an enemy burn?
I like this guy.
I'm not gonna use that one much.
I won't either. Let's see how much we can upgrade that.
We're doing this.
What are we doing?
We're doing this.
Good job bringing more people into our little I Hate Satan club. Why don't you take a rest?
Not interested. I got more shit to blow up.
I'm just saying I got a lead on where you can find a very nice chair.
You heard that correctly, by the way.
It has guns.
I'm in. Let's see what these things can do.
I think I remember this.
I saw which one it was, and I was just like, yes, we're doing this.
Alright, where's the chair?
I don't know.
Oh,
for fuck's sake, game. Look, I got you this far. Just search the box, okay?
I'm here if you want to just use my marker. Use me as marker.
Yeah, no, I had the GPS.
Whoa! Alright then.
This is one of the seven deadly weapons. One of them you have to buy.
Starting to feel sociopathic.
I love the recliner.
What is this classified as? This replaces our assault rifles, so I like that. What?
No one told me that on Kinsey.
Oh god.
Also, that's a thing. That
looks awesome. So, wait, which one is this? Is this sloth? I wasn't looking.
Yes.
Alright, then.
Okay, Kinsey.
What'd she say?
It's just like, she went, I'm just saying, Dane. Coldfire Aura Blessed Rounds. Adds random chance your bullets will beam are imbued with a cold fire effect while aura is active. If only I was gonna use the aura.
I mean, you have the souls, might as well use them.
I mean, I'm upgrading them, I'm just not gonna use the aura. Oh, there's the spire. Plague of God. Oh, leveled up. New flight ability, efficiency 3. Uses hardly any stamina at all. Ooh, soothe. Cold of fire aura makes you immune to fire while it is active and removes the fire effect immediately upon an activation. Weapon, SMG2, yeah, go ahead. Buy that. Alright, need level 20. Got it.
For what now?
SMG unlimited.
What do you need for rifle? Oh, wrong.
Also, I need a weapon shop.
Instant reload rifle's 18.
Whoa, that's an Omega, Omega, Omega. That's a Tri-Omega.
Ledge rush.
Actually, hold that thought.
Alright.
I found the first weapon shop we were at. I need to buy the hive mind. Before I run out, I need to buy. Oh no, it's 100,000. Never mind. I will wait. Because I just upgraded my the stinger thingy, the bees.
Not the bees.
I just upgraded that quite a bit. When do we get the collector finder? Level 15. but yes. Oh, you're busy. See how it is.
Not yet. I need to use that vendor.
Ah.
Where is it?
Under the bridge. Come to me. Under the bridge.
As much as I like that recliner, I'm swapping it out.
What?
You can't run while you're in the recliner. Sprint.
Okay. It's a recliner with machine guns built in. It's literally the weapon of sloth. I'm keeping it.
Alright, you keep it.
Comfy.
Alright. And instead, I'm going to be using this gun for a while.
All right. Oh, did you get... What gun are you using?
Let's go.
I forgot to see if I can upgrade this gun, this weapon at all. And I can! The first three. Also, there's a movement speed bonus for the chair. You can buy more movement speed.
Place your order. What?
Huh?
Okay, there's a thing behind this, this pledge rush. It says place your order.
Dane, if this is a dead drop, you shouldn't be using my name.
How did you know it was a dead drop?
It was obvious. There are three tacos malos in hell. The words tacos malos is made up of 10 consonants. Three tacos malos equals 310. Drop the zero and you have 31. And the 31 theory signifies a place of importance. The only question that remained was for whom was the space important. Now, alter is a five-letter word, like taco and malos, which means...
Yeah, I just like tacos.
That's disappointing.
You're telling me. Now listen up, I've been stashing resources at each of the branches. Swing by all three and you'll be able to build a weapon.
Did you hear Kinsey's?
Yeah, I heard your statement for it, not mine.
Okay. Okay.
Alright. Let's see if what Gat has
so,
what says
I
Gat.
Definitely missed the first part of that quote from Kinsey just now. Because the first part, the line read, yep, just tits deep in hell.
Welcome to Tacos Malos. Can I take your order?
Dane? Is that you?
Yes. Now keep your voice down before
the fuck are you doing in there?
You think anyone buys fast food in hell? It's a front. I've been stashing resources at the branches all over hell. Swing by all three and you'll have enough components to build a weapon.
Can I still get a taco?
Don't want the fucking tacos. Well, get out of here.
You don't want the fucking... Screw you, Dane! Alright, let's start this.